Is that one? Let's see. No. We are here in a rare spot of shade in this desert near Joshua Tree, catching our breath after about 3 hours of searching for the elusive Western Desert Tortoise. 8 decades ago, the vast Mojave Desert was home to hundreds of tortoises per square mile. Today, tortoise populations have fallen to 2 to 3 adults per square mile.
You know, people definitely contributed very, very largely to their decline.
We're really in an all-hands-on-deck situation with protection of the desert tortoise. If we don't change what we're doing, it's very likely that the tortoise will be extinct by the end of the century.
Conservation groups fear the Western Mojave Desert tortoise is headed for extinction. They are urging the California Fish and Game Commission to elevate its status from threatened to an endangered species.
3, 2, 1.
Ravens are omnivores. They eat everything. If we don't do some active management of ravens, we won't have tortoises.
This species is under siege from development, from climate change, from wildfires, from military maneuvers, from respiratory disease, and oh yes, we can't forget ravens. Do you remember a time when there were more tortoises than the ones we're trying to find out here this morning?
It was much easier to see them. I mean, just going through Mojave National Preserve, you'd see one every couple of days, even if you're just driving around.
I understand that they're at the limits of tolerance for temperature-wise. Have you noticed any diminishment of tortoise populations due to drought?
Absolutely. They are well adapted to the desert, but they are getting closer to their physiological limits. There's less rainfall, less food, and less reproduction.
Gopherus agassizii was listed as threatened over 30 years ago under a powerful piece of legislation that was among the first of its kind. In 1970, California helped lead the way when it enacted the California Endangered Species Act. The federal government followed suit 3 years later, improving the odds of rescuing wildlife dangling from the edge.
Each of us all across this great land has a stake in maintaining and improving environmental quality.
Despite the fact that tortoises are protected by federal and state laws in California, and actually by federal and state laws in Nevada as well, people are still building huge projects on tortoise habitat.
Tortoises have lived in the Mojave Desert for millions of years, even before the area was a desert. It's almost as close to a dinosaur as you can get in Southern California. I knew finding one in the wild was going to be near impossible. Desert tortoises spend 95% of their lives in burrows and under boulders.
Desert tortoises belong to a group of tortoises called gopher tortoises, and they get that name because of their habit to burrow. They have these really strong front legs you see here. They're real, real strong, and those are just big tractor plows. They dig into the earth really easily, and unfortunately, Slowpoke doesn't really have a full set, but she still gets around, she still digs.
They lumber out to look for food and water. That's when they can fall prey to one of the most intelligent birds.
We've encountered piles of dozens of dead tortoises under specific nests. And those ravens are tortoise-killing specialists. They're not really interested in the meat. They want the fatty organs like the liver. You're gonna see, and it's graphic. You're about to see some graphic stuff. Oh God, this place is so gross.
Tim Shields has a different approach to saving tortoises. He targets the ravens that eat them.
This is super high quality for ravens because it has food scraps in it, it has items of interest.
Shields has a contract with the Victorville Sewage Treatment Facility to use his high-powered laser pistols to scare off ravens that feast on wildlife, including baby tortoises.
There's this sort of group of ravens that's kind of keeping tabs on us. And we're definitely being watched full time.
It's hard not to think that the Western Desert Tortoise doesn't stand a chance against a predator this intelligent.
Without help, that's true. But I think we can give them help and tilt the balance more in their favor.
7 decades ago, ravens were hard to find in the desert, but their numbers exploded with the increase of food and water at landfills, dumpsters, sewage ponds, golf courses, and city parks. They belong here. The trouble is not in these numbers.
I'm not opposed to lethal control in certain circumstances. There's plenty of ravens. We could kill tens of thousands of them and not put them in any danger. I'm not saying we should.
Shields also uses 3D printed replicas of baby tortoises that, when pecked at by a raven, detonate a cloud of non-lethal but very irritating chemical. He calls them techno-tortoises. And then there's the quadcopter. It squirts silicone oil onto the eggs in ravens' nests, rendering them unviable. Wildlife authorities say their efforts are starting to pay off. They are seeing measurable declines in raven visits each day in some selected areas. We were ready to give up on finding a desert tortoise in the wild, but then we got a call about a sighting at a preserve in California City.
I don't see anything. No, it's empty. It's not in there. It went someplace. It's out.
He's got to be around here somewhere. Hi there, little miracle.
I'm wondering if he just came out. They like to come out also to just bask in the sun to warm up.
How often do you find a young, healthy tortoise that you haven't seen before?
It doesn't really happen that often, you know, and so it's a rather rare find, I would say.
Signs of recovery among tortoises in the Desert Tortoise Research Natural Area have renewed interest in installing fences at other, higher, cooler elevations where the animals stand a better chance of surviving droughts and rising temperatures due to global warming. The California Fish and Game Commission is set to make a decision later this year about whether to change the tortoise's status from threatened to endangered. Regardless of the outcome, it's clear to some that keeping desert tortoises alive isn't just the job of a select few.
It really needs to be every Californian, every Nevadan, working to make sure the tortoises have a shot at getting into the 22nd century.